हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर ज्यूडिशरी। देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन दैट डज एवरीवन हैव एक्सेस टू द कोर्ट्स। इन प्रिंसिपल ऑल सिटीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया हैव द एक्सेस टू द कोर्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री एज ऑल हैव द राइट टू गेट जस्टिस फॉर देम सेल्व। दे हैव द राइट टू बी हियर्ड एंड गेट देयर matters of victimization resolved, but in actually things are very different. There are very few courts and very many people in country. They have to move over large distances to register their petition and lodge FIRs. Then they need to hire advocates who would assess the legalities of their case and formulate the petitions. Subsequently, the cases get listed for hearings after long waits as the judges are very few. The whole process of litigation is time consuming due to the number of hearings and counter challenges by the opponents. This necessitates more time. The people have to leave their work to attend the courts again and again. Then comes the factor of cost. Large amount of cost of money are required for advocate fee, and many cannot afford these. It is because of these aspects that most people either avoid getting into the legal complications of the court procedures and accept their situation as part of destiny, or turn to the root of crime and take law into their own hands. In response, judiciary devised a mechanism of PIL, that is public interest litigation. The Supreme Court realized this problem of the poor and infirm and adopted in the early 80s a mechanism of public interest litigation, commonly referred to as PIL. This allows any individual or organization to file a case in the High Court or even directly into the Supreme Court on behalf of those aggrieved whose rights have been violated. The provision of PIL specifies that it is not for safeguarding the interest of any one person, but as the name suggests, has to be for a group of people. The PIL is even acceptable in the form of a letter or a telegram, so that the people in distant and remote areas also get a hearing at a fast pace. A large number of issues have got resolved through the system of PIL. The noteworthy are rescuing bonded labor, conditions of the suspects awaiting trials for years, and languishing in jails. The case for midday meal and prevention of national losses from rotting food grains in godowns. The courts have also instituted Lok Adalats or public courts, where there is direct access to of the aggrieved to the decision makers. These are mostly area or specific to particular services like electric supply, telephone department. The example of PIL is midday meal scheme in government and government aided schools is a result of PIL. In 2001, millions in Rajasthan and Odisha faced acute food shortage due to drought. Hunger amidst plenty, an organization filed a PIL in the Supreme Court regarding fundamental right to life, Article 21 of Constitution. This right includes right to food. States excuse of shortage of funds and grains was proved wrong as government's godown were full of grain. Supreme Court ruled that it is the duty of the state government to provide food to all. It directed the state government to provide food at cheap prices through ration shops and provide midday meals to children in the school. The judiciary is an important function of the state. It is in the art of governance. It is necessary to that the public feels safe, secure, and righteous. They should feel the system of governance and social order is fair and just. As long as the people trust in the judicial system, they will feel that their grievances are addressed. The old saying stands good, justice delayed is justice denied. Awaiting for years and years are just for justice makes life miserable for the aggrieved citizens. The Indian judicial system has stood the test of time and proved to be progressive, fair and just. So students, the chapter is over. Now write some questions and you have to write all the answers in your homework copy. Okay? Have a good day ahead. Thank you.